Hello, my name is Nathan. I have a blog where I review movies, and I thought maybe I'd convert them to a video for you. When I started my blog, it was very amateurish, so I'm not going to read every review because a lot of them aren't very good. But I thought that I would go through and kind of find the good ones, so to speak. And, all right. Got my COVID beard ready. Something I should mention about my blog is I was kind of following along the list called the 1001 Movies You Should Watch Before You Die or something like that. But I kind of stopped just doing those movies and started doing TV and video games and the like. And I was thinking maybe I'd start doing comic books soon, but that's neither here nor there. For the most part, biopics aren't my cup of tea.
You're gonna have to give him a moment, son. Dewey Cox needs to think about his entire life before he plays.
I found this one to be pretty good. It still had some of the problems I have with the genre. Overall, though, it was pretty entertaining throughout its 3-hour runtime. What I really liked about this movie was the cinematography. Also the music. Both were stylized to match the films of whatever year it was in Howard Hughes' life at the time. Oh, this movie's about Howard Hughes, by the way, whom I knew nothing about before watching this movie, but it sounds like it was an accurate portrayal of Hughes and how his life was. I enjoyed that it went through many genres and wasn't afraid to show the main character in a negative light. The filmmakers show his OCD behavior and his germaphobia as it overtakes his life until he regresses completely away from society. He was a person who rose above everyone, trying to make his vision of the future. And he was ruthless at bringing that vision to fruition, no matter the cost.
You just have turned up a lot of dirt.
You want to go to war with me?
What I didn't like so much in this movie was the length. I know some might consider this nitpicky, but I take movie length very seriously. Movies should be as long as they need to be, no more and no less. And if you make a 3-hour long movie, I better not be catching myself thinking things like, well, this scene could have been shortened, or this side story could have been cut, or this character serves no purpose to the story. The more I think those things, the more I start to notice how long your movie is. And though there was a lot I liked about this movie, it was bogged down by too many parts that were overtaken by cliche or just flat out boring scenes.